Dr. John Stein, director of NOAA Seafood Safety Program, explained the details of testing to Reuters. He said the chemical test is a backup for the so-called sensory testing. In other words, that's sniffing, you know, smelling with your nose, in which trained experts sniff seafood. I'm sorry, I don't mean to laugh in the middle of this, but it is such a joke. I'll get through it. I'll try to be more serious. Dr. Stein said the chemical test is a backup for so-called sensory testing in which trained experts sniff seafood for evidence of chemical contamination. The chemical test looks for, I've got to go figure out this word here, diacetyl sodium sulfosuccinate, or DOSS, one of the main compounds. Now listen to this, one of the main compounds in the dispersants used to break up the spilled oil. In other words, this is supposed to be a main compound, and correct, since that's the main dispersant, supposedly. And then I'm quoting what he said. DOS is also approved by the FDA for use in various household products and over-the-counter medications at very low levels. All right, so they're looking for this one chemical that's supposed to be in the dispersants, and that is their testing to say to say that the quote quote that it would not be harmful for humans. That's their quote. And also their quote, there's no question Gulf seafood coming to market is safe from oil or dispersant residue. Really? Okay, their test says so. Well, still, when the shrimp harvest began in August, many fishery experts expressed skepticism about whether the testing methods used by the federal agencies were enough. Douglas Rader, chief ocean scientist for Environmental Defense Fund, told the Washington Post, where he said the government has not done enough tests to guarantee that open areas are free of oil. Even if the test came back clean, he said, currents could bring in oil or oiled creatures afterward. The problem is all the dispersed components of oil that are traveling independently through the complicated ecosystems of the Gulf of Mexico. And Rader had said in that Washington Post, quote, it seems like a rush judge. Well, now they're rushed to do it again. That was back in August. They were going to say it was okay. Now they're trying to pull the same lie again. And I'll continue with the rest of this time article. And in terms of themselves, still somewhat wary of the loss of business because of the spill has been economically catastrophic for them. The impact of a single batch of tainted fish could be much worse. Oh, not could be. It would be. For now, the fishermen in Louisiana can at least count on one high-profile customer. President Barack Obama served Gulf shrimp at his birthday party in August. While there have also been some things on the internet to say that wasn't Gulf shrimp. It doesn't matter. If he was stupid enough to eat it, then fine. I think we ought to send all the shrimp and the fish that we have. We ought to send everything that's come out of the Gulf right now that supposedly has been tested by the Food and Drug Administration and NOAA, National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. I think we should donate all the shrimp and the fish and the oysters that are coming out of this mess in the Gulf and send it to Washington and let them just eat all of it for free. I think we should donate it. We should get together and donate refrigerated trucks or freeze it and send it up in freezer trucks. And let's just dump it all over the Capitol steps. How about that? Let's see if they really, really want to eat it. I'll guarantee you they won't, but that's what we should do. Because, you know, this is just a bunch of lying garbage. Now, you know, they said their test, that DOSS test, that's how they can find out whether there's any chemical dispersants in there. They're saying that's one of the major compounds. Wrong. 38% of corrects at 9,500 is made of 2-butoxyethanol, which that fancy chemical, that compound, is a paint solvent used to dissolve plastics. Now, that's 38% of the EPA-published ingredients of Corexit 9500. Corexit 9527A, which they say they've also been using. That published amount says 30 to 60% of 2-butoxy ethanol in it. So why aren't they testing for that? Since that's a minimum of 30% upwards to 60% of what supposedly is in the dispersants that they're using. Okay, see, this is the lies I'm talking about. This test, or DOSS test, it's not going to fly. And now they're liable for saying that it's okay to eat everything that comes out of the Gulf, the fish, the oysters, the crabs, the shrimp. They said, according to our test, 1,735 samples, only 13 had trace amounts of the chemical corrector. Well, what else was in there? They didn't test for crude oil. They didn't test for totally dispersed oil with bacterial agents that are synthetic that have been put there to break the oil up at an accelerated rate. Of course not. We're not going to test for something that would show the truth. This is just part of the lies. Come, just like the ad said, come to our restaurant. Poor people, I'm sure that they would have lost everything if BP didn't bail them out. Come to our restaurant. We got some fresh Gulf seafood coming in. Well, I'm not eating there, and I know that their neighbors aren't going to eat there. So I guess we're just going to have to convince people who don't know any better to come to the Gulf and get sick like we are. So if that's what we want, then fine. You know, the lies are the lies are the lies. Let's move on. Okay, BP's doing good right now. Did you know that? BP just returned to profitability. They made a profit in the third quarter. This just came out this morning. According to CNNMoney.com, BP returned to profitability in the third quarter, rebounding from the severe loss caused by the Gulf of Mexico oil spill, the company said on Tuesday. Well, that's today. London-based BP said it earned $1.8 billion U.S. dollars in the 3 months ended September 30th this year, people. Oh, they made a profit of $1.8 billion when what's going on in the Gulf, the real crap hasn't even hit the fan yet. And they say, we got the well. It's not leaking anymore. We're pretty much done. That could explain why there's a brand new drilling rig out there for some reason that nobody can seem to explain. Look, the whole thing is a lie. And anybody who listens to anything that comes out of BP, out of most, if not all of any local through federal government agency, including NOAA, and now I guess we got the FDA involved in a lying as well. If you're going to believe their lies, then fine. Keep your head buried in the sand or in a big manure pile for all I care. But if you want to know the truth, then stop listening to their lies. You can't listen to their lies. You people listening in the UK and in Europe and my friends in Germany, you know this is coming your way. You want to know what the jet stream is doing today? It's a little bit different than what we reported a month ago, but the North American jet stream acts normal till it gets to the midsection of the North American continent. And then it heads straight south. And right now it's heading straight down towards the border of Louisiana and Texas. And then it goes into the Gulf, and then it goes straight west and hits me right where I'm at on the west coast of Florida. So right now I'm getting all the crap out of the Gulf. That explains probably going back to my wonderful migraine that I've had since I was out feeding the animals this morning. Maybe that's making my attitude a little bit worse. But anyway, now that goes across the state of Florida as I'm speaking now, that jet stream, but then it goes up the eastern coast of the North American continent, and then from there it goes over towards the UK, and then comes down into the coastline of France. So, look, friends, I've got good friends in Europe. And I know that you're starting to listen now because I'm sending the email saying it's time that you know what's going on. You're going to get it. You know, wherever the Gulf wind blows and wherever the Gulf water flows, you're going to get BP surprise. And it is BP surprise. And all the governments here are part of the cover-up. They want to tell you everything is okay. It's not okay. And now BP, as of September 30th, just made a $1.8 billion U.S. dollar profit. How wonderful. While all my friends, all of them that were involved in any kind of fishing or even in restaurants around the Gulf Coast, especially my friends in Louisiana and Mississippi by Biloxi, all of them are out of business. All of them are in there with claims, most of them, I should say. Most have claims with BP on their program, and they're getting their claims turned down. So let's talk about that next. Let's talk about the real truth. What's going on with all this money that BP supposedly put in charge of the U.S. federal government? And we've got a czar handling all that. We don't have politicians or department heads anymore. Now we have czars. Well, here's a headline, and this is from AL.com. It's a news site on the internet where we got lots of reporters from typical local newspapers. And this one is from a reporter who I've quoted before in previous broadcasts, Dan Murtaugh, with the Press Register, and that's in Mobile, Alabama. So here's what he says. After a flurry of large payouts in late September and early October, the Gulf Coast Claims Facility, now that's the BP Gulf Coast Claims deal, has noticeably slowed the money flow in the past 2 weeks, much to the chagrin of officials on Alabama's beach community. Well, gee, they're spending money, BP spending the money on ads to shove in our face about how all our Gulf seafood is okay. I can't understand that. Oh, $1.8 billion profit. Yeah. Yeah, maybe that's connecting a couple dots there. $1.8 billion profit. Okay, just in the third quarter when things have been so bad. Of course, now, you know, BP's just slowing down because everything's okay now. Let's put up those nice ads to get tourists back and have people eat the nasty seafood. I'm quoting from the article again. We had that great uptick, and then it just died, said Orange Beach Mayor Tony Cannon. I feel like I'm back in the dark. The payments have shut off. Denials are going up, and we have no communication and no answers. Oh, gee, that kind of sounds like VP.